Hey guys, come on in. How's everybody doing? Today we are talking about three things that an unsatisfying job has taught me. We are still continuing that conversation tonight. Three things that an unsatisfying job has taught me. And come on in and share. I want you to share this information, especially with your friends and families that you know are in an unsatisfying job. You know you have a friend, a cousin, or it just might be you who's in that unsatisfying job. Hey, Cassandra, thanks for popping in. We're talking about three things an unsatisfying job has taught me. Come in and say hi. Let me know what city you are in. And if anything that I say tonight resonates with you, I want you to put an emoji in the box. You can give me a 100 or a footprint or a spade, just to kind of let me know that you are following me and that you agree with me or that you know exactly what I'm talking about. And so we're talking about three things an unsatisfying job has taught me. And so I wanted to talk to you guys because, you know, sometimes when you are in the midst of an unsatisfying job, there are some things that you may need to change or correct or improve, but you don't see it because you're in it. And so sometimes you need a second set of eyes or a different perspective or a little insight to kind of help you along your way. So that is why I am here. I want to give you some insight just to bring some things to your attention that you may need to be looking at as you're working your 9-to-5. And did you guys know about this statistic that 90% of people go home every day unfulfilled by their job? 90%. That's a lot, guys. 90% go home every day unfulfilled. And so that statistic really bothers me. And so I am on a mission to help you get out of your dull, boring, and stagnant job and helping you find a meaningful career so you can thrive again. And so tonight, my first thing that an unsatisfying job taught me is that I was living within my comfort zone. Who likes the comfort zone? Go ahead, raise your hand. We've all been there, or you might still be there. The comfort zone. So what I was doing, I was taking jobs and doing assignments that I knew I was good at, doing things I knew I could excel at, but I wasn't challenging myself. I wasn't, you know, challenging the status quo. And so that's how my circle or my cycle of unsatisfying jobs just kept going and going and going because I never challenged the status quo. I never did anything that challenged me. So if that's where you are, I want you to, you know, think about that. Are you in the status quo? Are you challenging yourself? And if you're not, there's something you need to think about because that will definitely keep you in an unsatisfying job. And guys, if you're just coming in, say hi to me. Let me know what city you're in. And share out this video with your friends and family, especially those you know who are in unsatisfying jobs and who need to do something about it. And so the second thing that an unsatisfying job taught me was that I was wasting my life away. And guys, it took me a long, long, long time to realize that, but I finally got it. I finally got the, you know, the unsatisfying job was just wasting my life away. You know, I started off in my early years doing temp work. I went for medical billing. I did retail to kind of fill in the gaps. I did medical collections. And then I started working with students. And so along my journey, you know, I found out I was wasting my time. And for me, my unsatisfying job journey started because I did not know who I was. You know, I had a very low self-awareness. And so that's important as you're looking for jobs. And when you're in your current job, you got to know the good, the bad, and the ugly about yourself. And once you know the good, the bad, and the ugly about yourself, you can make better decisions. You can make better career choices. Right, guys? Does anybody agree with me that you can make better career choices if you know who you are? It makes sense once you think about it. And so the third thing that an unsatisfying job taught me is I wasn't living my purpose. How many of you would agree that you were created on purpose for purpose? If you agree with that, give me a heart. Let me see a heart out there in the comment section. If you believe that you were created for a purpose and on purpose. And you know, the jobs that I had, if you know, when I honestly look back, they weren't my purpose. And I'm not saying your job has to be your purpose, but it should at least be an extension of your purpose. And so the jobs that I had were not even an extension of my purpose. And so guess what? That just perpetrated my cycle of unsatisfying jobs. And so I want you to know that you were created for a reason. You were created for a purpose. And you need to make sure that your career is an extension of that purpose so that you can be fulfilled and you won't be part of that statistic that says that 90% of us go home every day unfulfilled. And so I wanted to share with you tonight three things that an unsatisfying job has taught me. I hope that this was helpful and I hope it resonated with you. And so tonight, I want you to take some time to reflect to see if you're within your comfort zone as far as your work is concerned. I want you to think about that. I want you to think about, are you wasting your life away because you're in an unsatisfying job? And also, I want you to think about your purpose. Are you living out your purpose at your job? Is it an extension? Is your job an extension of your purpose? Those are the three things I want you to reflect on tonight. And if you can relate to anything that I said, I would definitely want to help you get out of your unsatisfying job into a meaningful career. I have an 8-week course coming up on September 19th. It is Redesigning My Career Suit. It's going to help you discover a career that suits you. The first 4 weeks, we'll talk about identifying a career for you. We'll talk about career roadblocks, and we'll talk about your mindset and how your mindset can hold you back from finding the job that's right for you. And then the second 4 weeks, we'll talk about personal branding, your resume, LinkedIn, and all the tools and resources you need for your job search. And so you can go out and register today at gum.co/redesignmycareer. And if guys, if you don't know who I am Shalonda Phipps. I am a certified career coach. I'm a life coach and I am an author. And I appreciate so much for you guys taking the time to listen to me tonight. And I hope it was beneficial to you. And if you guys want to follow me, I would love to have you follow me and be a part of my community. You can follow me on LinkedIn and you can also follow me on Facebook on my business page, Maximize Career Potential International. I'll give out tips, resources, lots of information there. I can support you there, motivate you there. You can also see all the products and the services that I offer on that business page. And once again, guys, like I said, thank you so much for listening. I appreciate your time. And I just want to remind you that don't let an unsatisfying job steal from you anymore. Don't let it steal your time away. Your time is precious. And so until we talk, you have a good night and take care. Bye bye.